This is a specialized Tactic 4 mountain bike helmet, and it retails for about $110. Believe it or not, that puts it on the lower end of the price spectrum for helmets from major brands. Now, this is a very good helmet. It's got great ventilation, it's lightweight. When I put it on, I see no part of the helmet in my field of view. Just a really good, comfortable helmet overall, but so is this helmet from Bikeroo. This was $25 on Amazon.com. At one point, I think it was on sale for $20, and kind of ticks all the boxes. This is actually very comfortable, very lightweight. It looks really good, and it even has a cool name. What's more, this meets all CPSC guidelines. That's a Consumer Product Safety Commission here in the United States. But would you wear this helmet and go mountain biking? Would you put it on your mother's head? Would you put it on your child's head? And for that matter, how do we know this specialized Tactic 4 is as safe as they say it is? Because it's got a specialized logo on it? Well, we wanted to find the answer to that question, and so we drove 4 hours to Virginia Tech to visit their helmet testing lab, where helmets undergo a battery of tests to determine their star score. Although more yellow stars are a better rating, much like a restaurant or a product, a lower star score means a lower risk of concussion. To determine the star score of our Bikeroo helmet, I hand-delivered 5 identical samples to undergo the same testing procedures as hundreds of bicycle helmets, ranging from $30 to beyond $300. And so let's start with the question, why should we trust Virginia Tech's helmet testing lab? In 2011, Virginia Tech began testing football helmets in an effort to increase safety on their own playing field, and it actually worked. Their tests were so effective that the industry began using their tests as a sort of benchmark, and players are now safer because of it.
There was only one 5-star helmet, and now you can't buy anything but a 5-star helmet. Back in my day, we had lap seat belts, and you didn't even wear those most of the time. Then they had shoulder straps, right? It's an evolution of safety. Same thing with the helmet industry.
And so Virginia Tech developed new testing procedures, and they expanded their helmet testing program to include other activities like road and mountain biking. For each of these sports, there's a completely different impact test and a different risk function that determines the star score. So let's talk a little bit about these star ratings. On their website, Virginia Tech publicly features the results from hundreds of road and mountain bike helmets, with our specialized Tactic 4 coming in 3rd place for cycling overall and 1st place for mountain biking. That's why it's the helmet I'm holding right now. With a star score of 8.55, your risk of a concussion with this helmet is lower than with a helmet that has a higher star rating. Of the 72 mountain bike helmets currently on the list, the top 25 helmets all have a rating lower than 12. But the lowest ranking helmet, which I actually owned at one time, scored a 24.98 and got 2 stars. And at that lower end of the spectrum, there's no shortage of helmets that cost over $100. But at the bottom of the list, there are quite a few inexpensive helmets, more than the top of the list. If we look at the best ranked helmets, the top 25, there's only one that costs below $100, and that's the Scott Argo Plus MIPS. That Scott Argo costs $80 and scores an 11.6, which is impressive. But as of right now, any mountain bike helmet with a star score of lower than 14 is considered very safe, and in that range, we actually have quite a few budget options like this Laser Churu MIPS, which costs $55 and scores a 13. Of course, there are other factors that determine the cost of your helmet, like comfort, fit, weight, styling, and aerodynamics. But from the standpoint of safety, looks like $55 is enough.
We almost exclusively for our star ratings use this. This is a Noxy head form. National Operating Committee for the Standards of Athletic Equipment. We think this is the most biofidelic, and it's designed for sport helmets. Our sensor package slides into this little channel here right next to the CG, and then we can mount this head form on whatever test rig we want and do our head impacts and then do our analysis. Any activity where you have a lot of horizontal velocity, you probably hit your head at some sort of an angle. So this is what we call an oblique impact test.
Dr. Barry Miller gave us a tour of Virginia Tech's helmet lab and even demonstrated how these tests are done on their oblique impact tester.
You know, the bike helmet industry probably has more helmets than any other industry, you know, football, hockey, et cetera. And it's the most tedious of all of our processes. We use a head form that sits on a halo, and the halo goes around the anvil. But you have to get the helmet in the right position, X, Y, and Z. And again, there's 6 locations, 2 energy levels, 2 trials. So that's a total of 24 tests minimum, probably in the area of 5 to 6 hours. And so it really measures, you know, those rapid head movements, both linearly, peak linear acceleration, and the rotational acceleration or velocity. As your brain tries to maintain its position inside the skull, those rapid head movements are putting pressure, strain on, you know, the brain tissue. Yeah, the helmets that better reduce those peak numbers reduce concussion risk. So you don't want these rapid head movements.
Now, while certain technologies like MIPS can reduce the risk of a concussion,
I started to realize really early on in our tour that there's only one surefire way to make a helmet safer: add more padding. And so it's no surprise that football helmets are vastly more resistant to impact than bicycle helmets. In fact, bicycle helmets are single impact. You crash once and you have to get a new helmet. Football helmets incur multiple crashes per day. And so there's a lot of padding in there, and they're actually quite expensive. And so I decided to ask Dr. Miller how a football helmet might fare in a bike crash.
If you were to take a wild guess, how do you think a football helmet would fare in a bicycle crash?
I think it would do very well, extremely well.
But while in football you might smack your head every single game, a bicyclist might only smack their head once in their life, if at all. And so bicycle helmet manufacturers go to great lengths to try and make their helmets safer without just throwing more padding at them.
Oh, I see.
See how that, so they're they kind of smear, then some are deformed linearly, but some are kind of twisted and bent to the side. And so that's kind of the rotational mitigating part.
Now, as I questioned the staff at Virginia Tech, they gave me very measured responses, especially when they weren't 100% sure about something. They were really, really clear about the fact that all these tests have to take place for them to learn anything. You can't just drop a helmet and look at it and say that would fare well or that wouldn't. Everything has to be done just so. And so I was really surprised to get a relatively straight answer when I asked them about action cameras and how they affect helmet safety.
I'd probably say it might be minimal. It kind of depends on its level of attachment and like how rigidly attached it is to the helmet. We have to keep in mind that these impacts are very, very fast, as you saw in some of the data. So what would be perceived as a very wildly different impact is really just only 10 milliseconds where that whole impact response is affected. So as long as that's not wildly different, you should be fine.
This is not a conclusive result. This was just kind of a gut reaction to the question, and it makes me feel a little bit better about riding around with a camera on my helmet. I also needed some clarification on their methodology. As I mentioned, bicycle helmets are single impact, and so one crash, the helmet's done, yet Virginia Tech tests the same helmet multiple times.
For each helmet model, we use 5 different samples of the same helmet model. And our locations are spread far enough apart that we don't get any deformation that plays a role in a different location impact. And so we use 6 locations and 2 energy levels. And we do 2 trials per test condition. So that's what requires us to use 4 helmets. And we usually ask for a 5th just because oftentimes we need to retest a particular location for some reason.
These impact tests are very precise. They know exactly where the helmet is going to be impacted. Now, this doesn't work in a real life crash because you can't plan what part of the helmet is going to impact the ground, but apparently only the part of the helmet that was actually impacted is affected. This is kind of as good as it gets. It's a completely independent helmet testing lab, and in fact, Virginia Tech allows you to put a badge on your helmet showing that it has been tested.
What do you guys charge for that?
So it's a no-fee licensing agreement. If a company signs a licensing agreement, they're free to use our Virginia Tech logos with compatible helmets rated on the webpage.
And so, if you're watching this video now, Bikeroo, you can now put that badge on the box that your helmet comes in because this now has a star rating. And surprisingly, this $25 helmet scored better than much more expensive helmets from companies like Giro, Troy Lee, Smith, and Endura. They're all more expensive, and one is even over $200. The Bikeroo helmet scored a 16.18. That's suboptimal, but it's still not bad. It's safer than a lot of helmets on the list. And as I said, much safer than some helmets I've owned. I've owned a helmet with a score of 24. And the helmets that were the best in their tests scored around 8. And so technically, this is not a bad helmet, especially for $25, but when it's your brain we're talking about and you can get a top-rated one for $55, I'd rather spend that extra money, but I've ridden helmets that aren't as safe as this. And so we have these helmet ratings as a resource. So let's say you look through there and you buy a helmet that has a really good star rating. Is that going to lower your risk of a concussion? Well, of course, it depends on what you're doing on a bike, but when compared to other helmets, the answer is yes, if you get the helmet you were actually intending on getting. What do I mean by that? Do you notice anything strange about these two helmets in front of me? You probably don't, because they look pretty much identical, except this is a $300 helmet with a really, really good rating. And this, they probably try to sell for $300, but it's actually counterfeit. This actually hurts what I'm about to do. This is a $300 helmet, but I guess stomp hard, right? Helmets are supposed to kind of break if they're impacted hard enough. There is a major crack in here. There's a huge indentation on the top of the helmet, but that's kind of like a crumple zone would be in a car. And here is a Specialized Prevail 2 counterfeit edition. Let's see how it performs in the stomp test. I was expecting it to like indent more or something. Oh my God.
They're actually killing people.
So now I'm wondering, this is another helmet I got on Amazon, but this is not a counterfeit. It's a unique helmet. It's made by Team Obsidian, super cheap. I think this was under $20 and it's CPSC certified, or at least it says it is. What happens if I stomp on this? Let me stomp it again. Give it a good hard stomp. Yeah. Like, if you're gonna counterfeit a helmet, like, why kill people? This is a cheap, cheap, cheap helmet. It's like as cheap as you can get. But it looks like it would actually protect your head. So this went from a fun video about helmet safety to a video about murderers, basically. So how do you know you're getting a legitimate helmet? Well, first of all, this is a $300 helmet with a carbon fiber mesh. Everybody is trying to counterfeit this. Nobody's trying to counterfeit $50 helmets and $40 helmets, or at least they'd be pretty stupid to do that. Different companies around the cycling industry have done all sorts of secret shopper exercises at bike shops, and almost never do you find a counterfeit helmet at a bike shop in the United States. Amazon and AliExpress, I got the Bikeroo helmet there and I got this one there. They don't want to sell counterfeit goods. It harms them, but they can't really police all of it. So if you want to be really, really sure you're getting a good name brand helmet, go to like Backcountry or Jensen, one of the major brands that's actually a dealer. Or if you are gonna get a helmet on Amazon, make sure that the seller is the actual company that you're getting it from. Don't get a helmet from a third party, especially not a helmet from a third party, unless you can verify that they're an authorized reseller for that brand. Now, if you watch this channel, you know it's a huge priority of mine to get kids on bikes. And so it was music to my ears when Dr. Miller told me they have plans to start testing youth helmets. If you have the means to donate to such a cause, I left a link in the description. And of course, make sure you write bicycling in there because they test a lot of different types of helmets. And we can actually do a lot of good and make helmets safer for the riders of tomorrow. And so thank you to Virginia Tech for being such a gracious host, giving us a tour of your helmet testing lab, and testing our Bikeroo helmet. If you are interested in this old Bikeroo helmet, I left a link below. I also left some links to some other options that I believe give you a good mixture of value and safety. I hope this video was informative. I hope it makes a whole bunch of you safer. I hope you learned something, and if not, I hope you at least found it entertaining. Thanks for riding with me today, and I'll see you next time. I wrote this article about why experts have a difficult time getting through to beginners. This article and many other articles written by some of the most interesting voices in mountain biking are available on my Substack. Not only that, but you'll get the video you just watched 2 weeks early with no ads. Get interesting articles, ad-free early videos, discussions, and help me break free from the algorithm on Substack. For maximum protection, properly to the head. This properly to the head per enclosed snug and yeah, if you read this, it would have been pretty obvious. This wasn't the real thing. They have a phone number on it. I wonder what happens if you dial this phone number.